What it dooski YouTube, it's your boy Minor Malcolm, checking in, checking out, back in this. And if you haven't guessed from the title already, I have a big announcement. One of my most anticipated shoes of all time. You know what that means. I have to review it. Anyways, what up guys? Long time no see. I know, life's been coming to me fast and I've been making no videos. I've been posting on Instagram, man. I've just been washed up as hell. But that's good. Some time off is always great, you know? Some time to revitalize, refresh, and reconnect with yourself. And more importantly, eat some dessert. So, let's cut right to the chase, man. You know why I'm here? I know why you're here. Let's check the shoes. So here we have them. The 2019 Red Jordan 4s. Baby. Honestly, I haven't even opened these myself yet. So I'm gonna open them with you guys for the first time. I just got them in my local Foot Locker. This is actually the fourth time they've been retroed since I think 1989. So these things originally came out way before I was born. And man, I'm excited to get these. When I first saw them, I think it was back in maybe 2012 or 2013. And I was back in high school at the time. Honestly, my mom would not let me skip school to get these shoes because she would beat my ass. But I'm glad nowadays I can just wake up, go to my local Foot Locker and pick these up. Starting with the box, we have that typical black cement box with the red Jumpman symbol with the flight underneath. And the size tag says black, fire red, and cement gray. And they retail for $265 Canadian, meaning living here in Ontario, they're about $299 after taxes, which isn't that bad for what you're paying for because this shoe is a must have in any collection. More importantly, let's get to the shoes, man. Hold on, let me get this box orientated. And there you have them. This is my first time really seeing them since this morning. This is crazy, man. We have the Nike Air symbol. We have all black Nubuck uppers, cement gray bottoms, a little air bubble at the back. These are, can't get much better than these, bro. When it comes down to these shoes, it's the shoe you've known to grow and love, except there's way more Nike Air branding all around, so it's a win-win. Starting with the upper, it's an all Nubuck upper in a black. Quality-wise, it's exactly what you expect. It's not gonna be anything that's gonna blow your mind, but they do definitely get the job done. Moving on to the midsole, we have all black paint all around with the white paint underneath, as well as that little air bubble peeking towards the back of it. The one thing I will warn you though about this shoe, as well as about Jordan 3s and even Jordan 5s, any shoe with the same kind of silhouette, and that painting on the midsole, they are gonna crack and crease. Honestly, it's not the biggest deal to me, but that's something to keep in mind if you're gonna keep these in your collection for a long time. Towards the bottom of the shoe, it's one of my favorite parts. Super simplistic, it's gray with the red Nike Air symbol on the bottom. That's super, super similar to the actual OG version, and that's one thing that's changed for the Jumpman over the years, which I can appreciate, Jordan brand. Boom, fire. In terms of differences, the only thing that's really changed is on the heel tab of the shoe, you actually have the Nike Air symbol as well on the inside of the shoe. On the insole, you have Nike Air on that fire red insole with the gray guts all in between. And just above that, you have that flippable Air Jordan symbol. So when you flip down the tongue, people can actually see what you're rocking with. All in all, man, it's a great shoe. I would say that if you haven't got these yet, you're playing yourself. They may still be available. I'll check right now. I'll leave a link in the bio, but you definitely need to get these. Oh, how can I forget? The most important part, I guess, in terms of like the collectibles, we also have the Nike Air hang tag here, which was lacking from the last pair last time. So that's definitely cool. A lot of people like to keep it on the shoe, but I think it looks kind of corny. So I'm definitely gonna take that off, but I want to keep it regardless. And yeah, man, that's about it in terms of sizing. Like most Jordans, I tend to go true to size. I'm a 10.5 in these. They fit perfectly fine. I would say though, if you do have a wide foot, you can definitely afford to size up because you'll just have that extra room. Other than that, I would love to know, what do you guys think of these shoes? Were you actually able to get a pair already? Or are you still waiting them to drop a little bit in terms of below retail now that there's so much stock? Who knows? I'm gonna say that people definitely won't hesitate to get 2 or 3 pairs of these, myself included. So don't sleep. If you can get these for retail, pick them up. Easily one of the most wearable shoes coming from Jordan in 2019. These are straight money. But that's about it, guys. I appreciate you tuning in. Make sure to like the video if you like the video. Subscribe if you haven't already. I'll catch you guys very, very soon with some more kicks. I hope I can get those Travis's, actually. My boy got a pair, and I might have some in my sleeve. Cool. I'll catch you guys on the flip side. Deuces!